Hello guys and welcome back again to the channel. On today's video, we will be looking at this new plugin from Analog Obsession. This is a transient designer called Trax. As you all know, his plugins are free, but if you're using his plugin, consider subscribing to his Patreon so that he can keep making awesome plugins like this one. And one other thing, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe and also hit that notification bell to get notified when I post new content. So let's get right in. As you can see, the plugin is quite straightforward. You've got the Analog Obsession button where when you click on it, it turns oversampling times 4 on, which helps obviously for clarity. And if you click again, it goes off. You've obviously got the attack, the sustain, and the output gain, which basically boosts the volume plus or minus 15, I believe. Yes, plus or minus 15. The sustain, if you go minus, obviously you are attenuating the tail of the audio. If you go plus, you are increasing, amplifying the tail. And this is the first attack. If you go back, you are attenuating it. If you go forward, you're obviously emphasizing that first hit of that sound. So let's listen to it on this so you guys can actually see how it works. If you are using like loops, you know, sample loops, because it's been compressed here and there, and obviously when you are mixing as well, you tend to maybe add compression here and there to gel the loops or the samples. So this always helps, especially with percussive elements. I always use this when I'm mixing, obviously not this one from Analog Obsession. I use other ones, maybe from Wave or the one from Kilohertz, which is also free and it's really nice. But this one, obviously, having come out today, I thought, let me give it a go and see how it is. So let's dive right in. So one thing you notice is having boosted that sustain, it actually pulls in all the room sounds because that's the tail of the audio. That is why something like a transient designer is also handy if you want to, say, take out a reverb from a sound. You just go the opposite way. So let's have a listen to that. As you notice, we're going minus is actually sort of cleaning up that kick and also making it sound less roomy and reverby. So obviously, it all depends on what you want to achieve. But usually when I'm using a transient shaper or transient designer like this one, I mainly just use the attack to actually get that initial hit to stick out more, basically to poke out more, so that if it's been compressed, you still feel it like something is actually happening, so it doesn't feel mushy and squashed. So let's back it off a bit. Let me also try it on this other sound. So I hope this is helpful, guys. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you've not done so yet, and also give the video a thumbs up. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye now.